Jamie Dimon, who is the CEO of JP Morgan Chase, recently commented on Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez's Green New Deal, and he claimed that it isn't very intelligent. Now, it's interesting that all of these frauds on Wall Street, who crashed the economy and are now fear-mongering about the Green New Deal's potential impact on the economy, as if they care about the economy and not their own short-term profits, they're now explaining that, you know, it could be the case that if we get too bold when it comes to climate change, this could harm the economy. Okay, but you dipshits do realize that if the planet becomes uninhabitable, the economy ceases to exist altogether, as does all of humanity. Like, you do realize that, right? Climate change poses an existential threat, and without a habitable planet, the economy itself cannot exist. They don't get that, because they don't want any plan to be codified into law that could potentially hurt their short-term profits. So obviously, this is an incredibly myopic and short-sighted way to view a global crisis that could lead to the extinction of the human race. But nonetheless, to them, all they care about is making more money. They don't care at all about the planet that we live on, because these old farts will be dead long before we see any of the most catastrophic consequences of climate change. So these are the people who are supposedly serious people. They're the adults who are telling us that our plan to aggressively take on climate change, well, that's what's not intelligent. Hey, moron, what's unintelligent is to do nothing as the planet burns to a fucking crisp. If we had an asteroid headed towards us, who would be unintelligent? The people who are choosing to take action or not take action. So you're not the serious person, you're not the adult, you're the dipshit who is perfectly fine with the planet becoming uninhabitable and all of us dying, because in no way would you risk hurting short-term profits of large multinational corporations. Well, I say, fuck that and fuck you, Jamie Dimon. Now, Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez came out and she explained why he's not a serious person in reality, and she explained why, when it comes to climate change, nobody should be taking anything that Jamie Dimon says seriously. Because as Jake Johnson of Common Dreams reports, Representative Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez reminded JP Morgan Chase CEO Jamie Dimon of his bank's massive investments in oil and gas development projects after Dimon suggested the Green New Deal is not an intelligent solution to the climate crisis. JP Morgan agreed to pay out $13 billion over its massive role in mortgage schemes in the 2008 recession, Ocasio-Cortez, freshman Democratic congresswoman from New York, said in a tweet Wednesday. They also finance major fossil fuel pipelines. It's big money. So maybe they aren't the best authority on prioritizing economic well-being of everyday people and the planet, she added. According to a report card released Wednesday by a coalition of environmental groups, JP Morgan invested $195.66 billion in oil and gas companies between 2016 and 2018, making the Wall Street Bank the world's top funder of fossil fuels by a wide margin. Ocasio-Cortez's tweet came after Dimon suggested in a CNN interview Tuesday that the Green New Deal would harm the economy and the American public. Can you focus on climate change in an intelligent way that doesn't damage the economy? Yes, you can. It's called CO2 emission taxes or trading, Dimon said. There are a couple of ways to do it, so you better do it wisely because you could hurt the economy, which hurts everybody. On Twitter, the progressive advocacy group Justice Democrats said the proposals Dimon mentioned are nowhere near the scale of what the climate crisis requires. And that's exactly it. The people who don't support the Green New Deal, they're saying, well, I think we should take action. They don't want to be grouped in with all of the climate change deniers. But what you fail to realize is that we have a very short timeline with which we need to act. The IPCC gave us 12 years. If we don't take substantial action within 12 years, then the planet will warm by 2 degrees Celsius, thus making catastrophic climate change inevitable. Now, even if we do take bold action, catastrophic climate change may still come to fruition. But the point is that we need to do what we can to save the planet, because we've got one habitable planet. And we shouldn't just be investing in climate change mitigation, but we need to be investing in adaptation as well, because climate change is already here. We're seeing the effects of hurricanes becoming basically a yearly phenomenon. It ravaged Puerto Rico, Texas. We're seeing more extreme weather patterns, and everything that scientists told us would happen is happening. But nobody's taking this seriously in power, and the ones who are claiming to take it seriously aren't taking it seriously enough, and they lack the urgency needed to address this issue. So all of these people who are telling us that the Green New Deal is not ambitious, and, you know, maybe it's not to my liking, but I do like the timeline, then make this a concerted effort. Write your name on it and improve it. Because the Green New Deal, as it stands, is a framework. It essentially aims to take action within 12 years. And that's what is needed to address climate change. And it's honestly the bare minimum, really. So, I mean, the fact that someone who is literally, he has a vested interest in not taking action because his bank has investments in oil and gas companies, it just goes to show you that this is what happens when you allow a capitalist system to exist with almost no oversight. You not only kill democracy because capitalism seeps into our democratic institutions, you ultimately end up possibly killing the entire planet. Yeah, well, I say to hell with that. We've still got time to act, and to all of the naysayers, put up or shut up. If you don't like the Green New Deal, propose something as equally ambitious. But they won't do that because they don't want us to take action, in spite of what they'll tell us. They just want to appear more reasonable, when in actuality, they're not reasonable. They're shills.
You could support the Humanist Report at patreon.com/humanistreport. But trust me, I'd have way more supporters on Patreon if that was my podcast. Sad.